I just love that opening bit. Alright, train simulator. Train simulator. Okay. Good fun game. Quite enjoy it. We're gonna do ECML London to Peterborough. You can do the first mission here. It's 35-minute duration, and it's a morning commute to Stevenage with a Class 801 train. I have done it. I've got a little bronze thing there, so let's do it again. See if I can do it better. Good morning, driver. Following a delay whilst preparing the train, we are running slightly late. You will need to proceed to King's Cross Station quickly as possible. Due to your departure time of 5:50. Close. Grant the speed, man. Let's go. Alright, we're on our way. Bring the throttle back now, because I don't know if you guys have played this game before, but we've got our little speedo here. So this small number is our speed limit, and the large number is our current travelling velocity. So if you speed, you do get penalised in your score, so that's mostly the reason why I've got bronze, because I have a bit of trouble maintaining my speed and keeping it under the posted limits, especially when it's like 10k an hour, mile an hour. I'm going to say mile an hour because this is England. go 20 now. So, like, you got the speed signs there, but something you might notice whilst watching this is your whole train has to get past the speed sign before you can actually do that speed. So, bring this back down again. So, like, we've gone past that 35, but it's still not saying we can do 35 because the rear of our train hasn't gone past it. Now, because the rear's gone past the 35, but the front's gone past the 25. Now we're limited to 25. So let's get our speed up to 25. And, I've seen some footage of this game, and it looks quite spectacular, really. With a good graphics card with a good system, you can make this game look quite nice. But, my system's not too bad, so I don't know. Obviously, I've just got the settings turned down. Either that, or it's the extra stuff that I've got running in the background. Let's get the speed up. Going so slow. We're in a rush. We're running late. But we don't want to speed. We don't want to get penalised. So bring that back down. 9%. maybe? 5%? Come on, get that speed back down. We're on a gradient? Yeah, we're on a gradient, that's why. We'll just coast down the gradient, I reckon. And you can see down the bottom in this box, shows the elevation of the track, and obviously all your signal lights and speed. Put your little train there. The faster you go, the smaller the ratio scale will get, or the larger the scale will get, the smaller your train will get in the display box. So it gives you a bit of warning, a bit more warning as to what's coming up, like a 40k zone. So we'll drop down to minus 3% throttle, which will start slowing us down a little bit. As we get closer, if we need to, we'll start actually applying some brake. Which I'm thinking might be necessary, because that's getting a bit close and we're only at 52, so we'll drop down to 21 minus, just so we slow down for that 40 mile zone. 15. It's a balancing act. No, most people would look at these games and think, oh, it's a train driving simulator. How fun could that be? You know, like you just get in there and, I don't know, you think you set some sort of cruise control and you're on rails. It's like the ultimate on rails game. But there's some fiddling, there's some thinking, there's some doing. So it's not too bad. I do like my simulator games as well, so you know, farming simulator and construction simulator and all those sort of things. Oh, we're not 65 mile an hour zone. Oh, we'll get up to 60. Well, King's Cross Station's coming up pretty quick. Let's get that speed up, and then we'll just start coasting down the hill. There's 60. And now we're in the 60 zone. Might actually have to apply some brakes. Even. Because that 35 is coming up real quick. Oh, gonna lose some points on this one. Oh yeah. Losing some points there for sure. Now I've got an amber light there, so definitely gotta slow down. That, and we're coming into a 15 mile an hour zone as well. Once arrived at King's Cross, release the doors and allow passengers to board before changing ends for the journey north. I think we've slowed down a little bit too much there. Speed up a little bit. Yeah, it'll work. King's Cross. We'll bring that speed down again. This downward gradient sucks. Just trying to to get the roll, but I don't want to roll too fast and get in trouble for it. And here we are, King's Cross Station, Platform 6. Creeping into the station. We could just stop right there. make him walk, I reckon. Make him walk. Actually, my train's a bit longer than I thought it was. Doesn't even look like it's coming in anywhere near the station yet. Hello, 3D. You want to catch my train? Drinking your coffee? Where's my coffee? Jeez, bit of respect for the driver, come on. And pulling in. Let's get a little bit more speed up. Get a bit closer to the end. Kill the speed. And load, unload. Then go to the other end. Alright. Now we gotta wait for this timer to finish. And then we'll be on our way. Time, did they say that we had to leave? 5:50? Pretty sure it was 5:50. So, we got, what, 3 minutes? Fiddling with the camera views. What is the guy talking on his phone? Oh, yes, that's right, yes. Yes, alright. Quick phone call. Oh, now he's looking, he's making another one. Yes, for sure, yes. Yes, you can have all my belongings. Oh, gosh. Can we have a look in some other. There we go. Ooh. Look at me. That just looks completely like me too. Really does. It's creepy. Oh, hang on. Check this out. There's me. There's me. That's like my twin. The other end of the train. That's just craziness, man. Absolute craziness. Look at how much my train is sticking out. What's going on with that? Anyway, this loading needs to hurry up. I don't even think anybody's actually getting on the train. No, nobody's even getting on. Oh, hang on. He looks like he's in a hurry. Come on, mate, you're gonna miss the train. I'm gonna leave without you. 5:41. Oh, yeah. Times match up. Gotta look at something while you wait. Look at... Oh, wow. Oh, they look so creepy. The guys don't look so creepy, but jeez, the females look creepy. That's some... They've all got, like, almost identical faces. Slightly different, but almost identical. I think there's maybe three or four faces. Oh, we can go now. Let's be on our way. Farewell. Catch you later. Ding 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 ding. I would hit the bell again, but I think it's a bit loud for around here. All my lights are red. Oh no, there we go, green. Green light. Gasworks tunnel line B. A, B, C? Or A, B, C? What do you reckon? I reckon A, B, C. But that's just because of how I'm looking at it. Alright, bring on this 45 mile zone. And then bring on the 65 mile zone after that. Let's get this party cranking. We've got... what is that? 10? 11 minutes? To get to... Potter's Bar Platform 3. Of course we're going to... Stevenage. But we'll be going via Potter's Bar Platform 3, so... we've got more than 10 minutes left. 10 minutes on the journey. It's about 20 minutes to get from King's Cross to Stevenage. So it's going to take a while, but 10 minutes to get to Potter's Bar, which is about the halfway point. Alright, there's 45 mile an hour. Let's go. See ya. Bye bye, peoples. And you're all exactly the same as that other train. Funny that. You can't blame them. The focus of the game isn't on what the passengers look like, or even so much what the surroundings look like, but more just to the trains and how they operate. And turn my lights on. Hehe. See ya. You waiting for my spot, mate? Here we go, 65 mile an hour. Then we've got 80 miles an hour, and then we've got 90 miles an hour. So we're getting there. Bring the throttle down. We don't want to speed. As with while we're on the road, don't want to speed. Get speeding tickets. It's one of the funny things, I think, is stare at the speedo, make sure you don't speed so you don't get a fine. But then you have a crash because you're staring at the speedo, making sure that you don't speed. So, bit of a catch 22. Cruise control is awesome though. I like cruise control. I do tend to use my cruise control, especially on long trips. If I've got to be going a set speed for, you know, like 20 minutes solid, then I'm gonna set that cruise control. You betcha I'm gonna set that cruise control. Kinda wish this train had cruise control. I don't have to stare at the speed, I can enjoy the surrounds. I wanna try and get better score than bronze. I've done any better than bronze, man, that's just sad. I don't even know if that, like, 0.8, point 0.8 over, am I gonna get in trouble for that? Not 0.8 anymore. Traveling by train is so much faster. And obviously the actual travel portion is faster. But getting to the train station and all that is it does take a fair bit longer, especially if you gotta do the whole trip via public transport. And for me to get into the city, it's like, I don't know, 40 minutes. If I was to drive in. But then, if I was to take public transport, I'd be looking more at an hour and a half. So, but if you travel by train, some routes that you travel by train is so much faster than driving. Say you tried to race the train from station to station, that train is going to beat you. There's no way around it, because they don't have to worry about oncoming traffic, pedestrians, intersections, slow people, not knowing how to drive. In saying that, the trains still have to deal with traffic, but it's a lot safer when these traffic signals stop them before they get too close to anyone. Master Control Center, whatever they might be called, Rail Control, they got a pretty close eye on everything. Push her over. Going fast. It's 115 mph, we're going 102. What am I doing? Not paying attention to the speed enough. Just looking at the surroundings. Thinking I might have to have a look at the graphical settings on this game and see if we can bump them up. Make it look prettier for next time. How's that sound? You guys like the sound of that? I certainly like the sound of that. We're gonna be good. Try and sharpen everything up. Give it more details. Str- tunnels makes me want to go for a ride. Get the tunnel exhaust sound. Nah, I don't do that. I don't do that at all. It's naughty, terrible things. So rude. All those people around me with their blown eardrums. They're deafening the old people. Let's have a look at this dashboard. No image expected here. What image would be there, though? Remote exterior lights and controls. Oh. Markers. Oh, headlights. Cool. Cool. Dimmed. Cool. Off. Tail. Markers. Data entry. Fan. Oh, can't turn the fan on. Devastating. Reading light? I can turn the reading light. Desk illumination. Turn that up. So from the outside. Nothing? What a surprise. Wow. Seems a bit brighter now, doesn't it? Brake. Is it that one that I'm controlling when I do that? I don't know. Master key. What's that? Directional lever. Oh yeah. Forward and reverse. Door closed to lock. CT wheel vents. Train door controls. Door release signal. Line voltage. Emergency brake, snow brake. Hit the emergency brake, watching on the floor.
Wow!
Push and pull. Fails. Temporary isolation faults. Train stop override. Overspeed. Percentage. Is that percentage of throttle or percentage of power? I wonder. Because it's not showing anything. Vroom. It's pressure. Brake cylinder pressure. Okay, reservoir and brake cylinder. Yeah, so air brakes are good. Couple preparation. Doors, sander, train wash, ETCS acknowledge, AWS acknowledge, pan up, pan down, train fault, horn. Just want little horn, not big horn. Wipers. Oh, there goes. Interesting. Fun. Good stuff. Mmm. Am I speeding yet? Ooh, no. But I'm going a bit slow. What do we got? Stevenage Platform 3 at 6:11. ETA is 6:10. Ooh! We're actually running on time. A little bit ahead of time. That's good, because I'll probably end up slowing down too much at the end of the road. And we'll be late. Because I'm pretty bad at that. 21%. Oh, 125 miles an hour. Yeah, boy. What's the fastest you've ever travelled altogether? I was either 400 or 600 kilometers an hour. I'm not sure. How fast does a check go? I know they're quick. I don't know. 600? 400? Yeah. Boeing 747 from Perth to Melbourne, and then obviously from Melbourne back to Perth again. They had to come home, so I wonder if the little jets go faster than the big jets. And powder weight. Well, no, it's just big jets have got far bigger jets, so that makes up more powder to one. I don't know. I suppose they could go faster. Fighter jets would go faster than the Boeing 747, that's for sure. So I'd imagine like a Learjet or something like that would be able to go faster than a Boeing 747, an Airbus, an Ambulance, no. It's gotta slow down. Gotta slow down. This is gonna ruin my ETA. Come on. Still got 2 miles. Oh. Oh, that's damage. Okay, yep. We'll slow down now. Two miles to slow down. 90 miles an hour. Is that excessive? No, it's not. Because that's coming up pretty quick. Red signal there. Oh, don't make me blow through it. Oh, there we go. It's gone amber. We have a train. Pulling into the station. Slowly but surely. There's no rush. I'll just use this one. I know how to use this one. I'll just roll in that last little bit. Just roll it. Rolling. Come on. Don't walk too far, people. I'm gonna pull it right into the station. press that button. Now, how bad was that? Where am I? Is that? Oh, that's pretty bad. That's probably pretty bad. Let's go to the other side. Yeah! Wow. I kind of overshot that a little bit. That's alright. It's not the end of the world. And there's my door. And go outside. Turn it around. That's my door. Doesn't look like there's any other doors there. Well done, driver. You managed to complete all of your tasks successfully this morning. You are now scheduled for a short break. Score. Close. Alright. Speeding 6 times. Whoops. Stopped at 0 of 0 destinations. Picked up passengers at 2 out of 2 platforms. And 0 out of 0 freight. And refueled 0 out of 0 times. So, what have we got? 35 minutes and 17 seconds of experience in class 801, and we've travelled 32 miles or 52 kilometres. Score. Seems good to me. Let's have a look at the settings actually while we're here. Master detail. Highest. Full screen, yes. Dynamic lighting. No, we don't need dynamic clouds, do we? Actually, let's go advanced. Yeah, that's all good. Procedural flora. Ah, so it's not actually a set map, it's all procedurally drawn flora. Adaptive bloom, depth of field, headlight, flares, yeah, it's all good. Previous. Alright then. Gameplay. Simple controls, auto fireman. I hope there's no fires. Let's go auto for that. passing danger signal ends the game. No, because I've done that before. Auto braking, allow all coupling, auto pause, show intro video. Volume, sensitivity, tools, credits, cancel. Alright. Well, there we go. So, main menu. That was Train Simulator, first mission. It's only a short one, which is good, because I didn't have time to play a long one. So, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, be sure to come back for the next one. There'll be Train Simulator again on Tuesday next week, and tomorrow I'll be uploading a homeworld, so it runs along the lines of my Minecraft Monday, Train Sim Tuesday, Homeworld Wednesday, Random Video Thursday, Farming Friday, Rise of Nations Strategy Saturday, and SimCity Sunday. So, yeah, that's it. Alright, I'll catch you good people in the next video, and until then, enjoy your gaming. Catch you later.